This video outlines the various settings and options available for the floor plan representation of railings in the Railings Settings dialog of ARCHICAD. If we activate the Railings Settings dialog, we will find a hierarchical tree structure of railing sub-elements on the left pane. On the railing page of the dialog, we can find multiple panels. Several of these provide settings and parameters for the exact specification of how the railing's floor plan symbol is generated. The Floor Plan Symbol Layouts panel contains the Use Display Settings of Associated Stairs checkbox at the top. When the railing is placed associatively on a stair and this checkbox is checked, the Host Stair settings will define how its associated railing is displayed on the various stories on which it appears. All other settings of the panel apply to all other cases of placed railings. Cases where the railing is associated to a wall, slab, roof, or mesh, not a stair, or when the railing is not associated to a host element. These settings also apply when the railing is associated to a stair, but the checkbox at the top of the panel is unchecked. The Show On field offers 9 different options. These define on which stories the railing's floor plan symbol will be shown. These options may be familiar from other element types. A story is relevant to the railing if the railing's vertical extents fall within the story's vertical range. Stories can fall into one of 5 categories in terms of their relation to the railing. As an example, let's consider a railing the home story of which is story 0 and extends vertically into story 2. The project file has 5 stories from story minus 1, basement, all the way up to story 3. For this railing, stories 0, 1, and 2 are relevant stories. Out of these, story 0 is the relevant bottom story. Story 1 is a relevant middle story. There can be more than one of these. And story 2 is the relevant top story. Story 3 and above fall into the category of above relevant story, while the basement and below fall into the category of below relevant story. You can specify the railing floor plan display layout for each of these 5 story categories separately, which means that on the various stories, there can be up to 5 different ways the floor plan symbol is displayed. For each of the story categories, you can define whether there will be a break mark displayed or not, whether the below break mark or above break mark portion of the stair or both will be displayed, and whether these parts will be displayed using visible or hidden graphical representation. Thus, there are up to 9 different floor plan display layouts available for the various story categories. 5 additional layouts are available for the relevant middle story, since it can display 2 break marks. This means that a break mark will be displayed, and the portion of the floor plan symbol below the break mark will be displayed using the visible graphical representation, while the portion above the break mark will be displayed using the hidden graphical representation. The other 8 options offer various combinations in which the break mark, the part below the break mark, and the part above the break mark are visible or hidden, and in which the below break mark and above break mark portions are displayed using either the visible or the hidden graphical representation. You can set the desired option for each story category separately. The panel also contains the Component Visibility and Detail Level field. Here you can define which components or sub-elements of the railing floor plan symbol are displayed. By selecting the By Model View Options radio button, you can specify that this is regulated by the currently active model view option combination. For details, please watch the clip titled Railing Model View Options in this playlist. Using this option is useful if you want your railing to follow an office standard in terms of 2D graphical representation. If, however, you wish to specify a custom floor plan symbol for the given railing, you can select the Custom Radio button. In this case, whether or not the visible and hidden portions of railing sub-elements appear is controlled by the 2D representation of each sub-element in its own settings page in the Railing Settings dialog. The next panel provides floor plan symbol overrides. By default, all sub-elements of the railing floor plan symbol have their own settings and parameters by which you can define their exact 2D representation. At the same time, you have the option to display the whole floor plan symbol of the railing with a single line type, pen, and fill type. The Override panel provides you with the Settings field to do just that, just as with other GDL objects. The third panel, related to the 2D representation of railings, is the Breakmark Settings panel. These settings control how the breakmark part of the railing's 2D representation is displayed. The Use Breakmark Settings of Associated Stairs checkmark at the top of the panel enables you to use the same breakmark settings for stairs and their associated railings. Please note that this checkbox and the Use Display Settings of Associated Stairs checkbox of the Floor Plan Symbol Layouts panel work together. Checking or unchecking one will also check or uncheck the other, and vice versa. In this panel, you can define the vertical breakmark position. You can set it so the position can be derived from the floor plan cut plane height, or it can be set to a custom height value. With this option, you can define a height value for both breakmark lines. There are also settings for the breakmark distance and angle. You can set the distance between the two lines and set their angle to either the horizontal or the vertical. Additionally, extension values can be defined for the extension of breakmark lines beyond the width of the railing. In the lower part of the panel, you can specify the line type and pen for both the lower and upper breakmark lines. The settings in this page apply to the railing as a whole. Additionally, there are settings for each sub-element, which allows you to specify the 2D representation of each one. Please watch all of the other clips in this playlist as well to fully familiarize yourself with their capabilities.